Dear children, in the last chapter, Principles of Inheritance and Variation, we learned about the inheritance pattern and we also understood that there is a genetic basis for the same. And in this chapter, Molecular Basis of Inheritance, we are going to understand the molecules which is involved in the inheritance of characters. Dear children, after many years of Mendel's discovery on factors, the nature of the genetic material was investigated and it was realized that there are two types of genetic materials, that is the nucleic acids, and the nucleic acids are DNA and RNA. What does DNA stand for? DNA stands for deoxyribonucleic acid and RNA stands for the ribonucleic acid. And this DNA is considered to be the genetic material in most of the organisms, whereas RNA is the genetic material in some viruses. And not only it is acting as a genetic material in some viruses, it is functioning as a messenger. It is functioning as an adapter. It's having structural function, and also in some reactions it is acting as a catalyst. So these are the different functions of RNA. So the two genetic materials or the nucleic acids are the DNA and RNA, and DNA is the genetic material in majority of the organisms. It is believed that the DNA is the most interesting molecule in the living system. So it is really amazing to learn the structure of the DNA. So let's learn the structure of DNA. The DNA is a polynucleotide chain. That means it is made up of repeating units called as nucleotides. So the monomer is a nucleotide, and these monomers, the nucleotides, they are joined together to form a polynucleotide. So DNA is a polymer of nucleotides which forms a polynucleotide. So both DNA and RNA are polynucleotides. A nucleotide, which is a repeating unit in a polynucleotide chain in the nucleic acid, is made up of three components. What are the three components? We have studied it in class 11 in the chapter Biomolecules. So we'll have a quick revision of the same. The nucleotide has three components. It is having a nitrogenous base, a pentose sugar, and a phosphate group. So three basic molecules make up the nucleotide. They are a nitrogenous base, a pentose sugar. Pentose means 5 carbon atom containing sugar, and a phosphate group. With regard to the pentose sugar, it is a ribose sugar in RNA. What is RNA called as? Ribonucleic acid. Whereas in the case of DNA, it is a deoxyribose sugar. Is it clear? So the sugar in RNA is ribose, and whereas the sugar in DNA is deoxyribose, as the name indicates. So it is made up of three components. Three components together make a nucleotide. They are a nitrogenous base, a pentose sugar, and a phosphate group. This nitrogenous base, which is a component of the nucleotide, they are of two types, purines and pyrimidines. As we can see the structure of purines, they are adenine and guanine. And what is the difference with respect to the pyrimidines? They are double ringed structures. Whereas pyrimidines are single ringed structures. So the double ring structures, purines are adenine and guanine. I repeat, the purines are adenine and guanine. Whereas the pyrimidines are of three types, cytosine, thymine, and uracil. So three types of pyrimidines, cytosine, thymine, and uracil. And here we have to note that thymine is present in DNA, whereas the pyrimidines which is present in RNA are cytosine and uracil. Thymine is absent in RNA. So instead of thymine, the RNA has the pyrimidines, cytosine and uracil, whereas the pyrimidines in DNA are cytosine and thymine. So the two types of nitrogenous bases are purines and pyrimidines. Purines are adenine and guanine, which is same in both DNA and RNA, whereas the pyrimidines are cytosine, thymine and uracil. The nitrogenous base is attached to a pentose sugar to form a structure called as a nucleoside. So initially, the pentose sugar joins to the nitrogen base. I told pentose sugar is having 5 carbon atoms, and we can see the position of the carbon atoms. It is respectively, see, this is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And to what position is the nitrogenous base attached to the pentose sugar? It is at which carbon atom? Yes, it is attached to the first carbon atom. So at the first carbon atom, the nitrogen base is attached. And what is a bond called as? It is called as an N-glycosidic bond. So with the help of an N-glycosidic bond, a nitrogen base, which can be a purine or a pyrimidine, is attached to the pentose sugar at which carbon atom? At the first carbon atom, with the help of an N-glycosidic linkage, or it's called as an N-glycosidic bond. And these two combine together to form a structure called as the nucleoside. It's called as a nucleoside. We can see the different nucleosides in RNA and DNA. Adenine combines to the pentose sugar and it forms a nucleoside called as adenosine in RNA. Whereas when adenine combines with the pentose sugar, the deoxyribose pentose sugar in DNA, it is called as deoxyadenosine. In the case of guanine, when guanine is attached to RNA, it is called as guanosine. The nucleoside is called as guanosine. And the nucleoside in DNA, when guanine is attached, is called as deoxyguanosine. When cytosine is attached to the sugar in RNA to form a nucleoside, it is called as cytidine. Whereas the nucleoside in DNA, when cytosine is attached, is called as deoxycytidine. And the case of uracil, the nucleoside in RNA is called as uridine, whereas in the case of DNA, the nucleoside is called as deoxythymidine. Is it clear? Uracil is present in RNA and thymine is present in DNA. So nucleosides in the different nucleic acids, that is the RNA and DNA, is given in this box. And after that, the nucleoside has to form a nucleotide. So what are the components which form the nucleoside? It is a pentose sugar, which is attached to the first carbon atom with the help of a glycosidic linkage to a nitrogen base to form a nucleoside. And to this nucleoside, a phosphate group comes and attaches. And to which carbon atom? In this figure, you can see it properly. To which carbon atom is a phosphate group attached? It is attached to the fifth carbon atom. Yes, it's attached to the fifth carbon atom. And thus, it forms a structure called as the nucleotide, which is the monomeric unit in the polynucleotide chain of the genetic material or of the nucleic acids. So, nitrogen base plus sugar plus phosphate group, it forms a nucleotide. Is it clear? In the case of DNA, it's called as deoxyribonucleotide, whereas in the case of RNA, it's called as ribonucleotide.